absolutely buzzing again to be in Flex Magazine. You need to grab this one. How am I gonna know if I'm in it?
You have to make a punt, aren't I?
Well, I'll get it anyway.
I should just take out a subscription, shouldn't I?
Yeah. It is page 34.
Oh, look at that! It's called the full package.
Oh, look at this.
Bossed it.
Absolutely buzzing again to be in Flex Magazine. You need to grab this one. Big old Luke Sando on there, looking sick. And then you need to turn to this page. Flex Magazine.
Muscle Fitness.
Fuck off! I was about to get it right!
No, you were!
I was about to nail it!
Oh, this could be a hilarious day.
Oh my god, I'm literally going to kill
it. Let's just keep going. I just think we should just, yeah.
I vote we sack Dan.
I vote we sack Dan as well. That suits me fine, because at least everyone will be on time. My business. Everyone will be on time, so
look,
it's fine.
Team Meek, it's over there, look.
Yeah, team on time.
So we're on calf raises first. So on this new program that I've put together, I've got the lying leg raise. Lying? It's not lying, it's just a leg raise. First, just to work the abs and also calves. The reason is because when I train legs, I tend to go a little bit too heavy for my own good and then fuck myself up so then I can't actually do calves and abs after. So this way, get it done. That way I can bring up my legs and my calves even before I then go on to squats and those other bits and bobs really. But I've always had really weak calves just because I don't really know how to train them very well. So what I'm typically trying to do now with the calf raise is focus on rolling my foot round rather than just pushing up, but try and roll my foot round and then try and push through that top of the calf as much as possible. So I got shorts on. Yeah, I got shorts on. So as you can see, they're not the biggest. They're not like Dan's calves, but you know, gotta grow them. We've all got our weak areas. Squats! This is the waist trainer. No, the lifting belt. So it just helps me brace my core and really press my abs into it. Keeps my lower back nice and tight, core nice and tight. Yeah, also just a bit of peace of mind, you know? Whew. Nice. Probably had a couple left in there, but no point risking it today. The 140 there, I think I did 8 reps, but for me that's probably, going by how I feel today, I've got at least 2 more in there until I start to see technical failure on my form, and then I could probably grind out another couple. So, you know, it felt hard at 6, don't get me wrong, like to the point where I was like, oh, can I do more? And most people stop as soon as they question themselves, can you do more? But again, knowing you've got people around you that know how you train, like Dan, he's given me feedback all the time, like, you've got another, so I know that I can do another, because sometimes when they're watching for bar speed, your movement, your form, whereas you can't worry about that when you're lifting. So yeah, like, I think there's different stages of failure, and it is important for me anyway to go very close to technical failure, but I'm not going to the point where I can't recover from it, because as soon as form breaks down and you start grinding those reps out, yeah, it's gonna be okay for a couple of exercises, but you consistently do that and you're gonna end up injured. So yeah, it's striking that balance between creating a stimulus to actually grow from and not doing too much. And that's really that art of training, in that sort of self-periodization as you go through prep, because days can be very different. I did this same session, 6 days ago, and it felt completely different today. Like, today was much easier. So you've just got to take each day as it comes. Always love your weights. Filthy.
You can run the mile, you can walk straight through hell with a smile. You could be the distance, you can run the mile, you can walk straight through hell with a smile.
So pretty decent session, just kept it real simple today. Did some abs, calves, squats. They're three different exercises, not one. Then we went on to some Romanian deadlifts and then some bicep curls. One of the biggest challenges I think I've had over the last sort of, well, probably since Christmas actually, what with Team Box and client updates and everything like that I've had going on, just been getting the time to get to the gym really. And because the gym's about a 30 minute drive away, and I've really struggled to park in my house, which sounds like a shit excuse, but actually, yeah, I can't keep affording parking tickets. So, if I don't get a space, I'm in trouble at the weekend. So, yeah, I've just been limited, really, by the amount of sessions I'm able to get in. So, this was the first week I got in 5 sessions. Normally, I'm, you know, some weeks 3 sessions, typically 4, but this week was a 5-week session. And what I did today was I just kind of ad hoc put in some bits and bobs what I thought I could probably push those a little bit harder this week just to sort of finish off the week really quite nicely. It was good. Went up to a 140 for 8, I think, for squats, which I was happy with. I haven't gone near that weight in months. So, you know, I was pretty happy with that. Had a good, rep amount yesterday on bench press. I did 110 for 10, so that was quite nice to be lifting that. And that was at the end of the workout as well. And what I've done with my bench press is I'm only doing 2 chest exercises a week. And the reason for that is because my chest is my strongest muscle group. Not physically, well, it probably is physically actually. Physically my strongest muscle group, and also how it looks proportionately. So what I've done, put only 2 exercises in the entire week, and they go at the bottom of my program because I want to focus bringing my back up and also more delts. They take priority in the session format. Fuck knows where I got to. So, are you filming this? If you're wondering why this video is real short, it's because just can't film anything. Kept running out of battery and now we're home. So, I was basically talking for 20 minutes and didn't film a single thing. But I'll try and remember what I spoke about. Split upper lower 4 times a week. 6 to 7 exercises per session, just really trying to focus on bringing up the back and the shoulders at the moment and putting as much frequency and volume and priority on those muscle groups really. But yeah, one of the biggest challenges I think a lot of people have when they train, when they're in prep, is that they try and go balls to the wall every single session. You know, day to day, you're gonna feel very differently. You know, when you go through a diet, your sleep's gonna be disrupted. You're gonna be hungry. Some days you just feel like you're training on empty. DOMS, you know, or like your recovery might be impaired from training. So you just can't do it. You cannot go to failure every single session. And I think there's different stages of failure as well. I mean, for me, there's like a true failure where physically that bar is not moving anywhere. And there's actually very few exercises where literally the bar's not gonna move anymore, because what will happen before that happens is you'll change the muscles you're working, or you'll change your form, or you'll change the movement in order just to move the bar from A to B. So I try and avoid that, and I just try and focus on training my muscle and taking that to failure. And that for me means where form is on that verge of breaking down. So that's why when I train, you'll notice I train quite slowly with my eccentric reps, because all the time I'm thinking, am I going to be able to do another? and providing I'm keeping that tension on, then yeah, we're going to be all good. And this is kind of one of the things that I spoke about in the Flex magazine. I just went over my five top points, and one of those is about taking the muscle through full range of motion. And for me, that means not just, you know, bench press. I had this question literally the other day, you know, should a bodybuilder touch their chest with the bar? And it kind of depends really on, you know, a few different factors. But, you know, it again depends on, first of all, why you're using the bench press as a tool in the program. Is it just to get a bit stronger? Because the bench press does actually become a bit more of a whole body exercise. You know, you've got the tension in the quads, the hammies all pushing through the floor, you've got the core stability, you know, you're using your lats as well to, you know, to press into create that width and push it into the pad, and then you've obviously got delts in triceps along with the chest. Whereas if you're using more of the bench press than using it with, like, you know, particularly elbows wider, and you're focusing more and using it as a chest press, then yeah, that's a different, completely sort of different exercise really, and should be thought about differently. But with, for me, the chest press, what I'm trying to do as a bodybuilder is build the biggest chest I possibly can, and for me, I want to be able to maintain tension on that, on my chest, as much as I possibly can. So for me, if I go so low as to the point where my shoulders round and come forward, then I'm going to put a lot of stress on the joint there, and actually that's then going to take that tension away from my pec. So for me, I've got quite good mobility, flexibility, whatever you want to call it, or good range with my pec, and I am able to touch my chest, pause, and then initiate the pec, and then carry on squeezing through right until the end. Whereas otherwise, or with other people, they're probably not able to do that, so they might have to stop, you know, half an inch off their chest, but that certainly doesn't mean do half reps, which we do see a lot of, and that's where someone's ego just gets potentially in the way, and they're just focusing on the weight, the weight, the weight, the weight. And it's the same for squats or whatever exercise really, you know, dumbbell row, you name it, it happens all the time. So it is a case of, can we just keep these muscles under tension for as long as we possibly can? And I'm not talking about like 5 seconds down, 5 seconds up. I mean over the reps and sets. So yeah, that's one of the biggest for me factors that I try and focus on when I am training. And then like machine setup comes into play, and again I go, you know, talk into about that in the article, and if people are interested, comment below and I can do another video on like machine setup, because again that's really important, because everyone's different, and when, you know, people design machines, they don't have you in mind, unfortunately. They have the general population of people that go and train, so everyone's slightly different stature, limb lengths, bits and bobs, literally people have, you know, different size bits and bobs. But yeah, you got to just get that machine set up for you, otherwise you might not target the muscle groups that you want to target because you're just sat in the wrong position. So yeah, bear those things in mind really. And yeah, if you do have any questions, please comment below, and while you're there, you may as well subscribe, because I'll be putting out obviously more regular content about training, nutrition as I go through prep. Already prep brain starting to kick in, I can feel it. Getting a little bit more rambly with my conversations now, but I'm in a good place, so all is good. Am I maintaining strength? I'm maintaining strength, which is good. So yeah, so far so good. I'm looking leaner. You still filming?